Hi there, this is Hackrich. In this video, we are going to discuss about format string vulnerability and how can we utilize this vulnerability to leak the content present in the stack. So let's get started. So this is simple C code. In main function, there are three variables declared, right? ID, age, and name. And we are going to print that information using a printf function. So whenever there is a function call, what compiler does is it will push the function parameter in a reverse order. So first it will push the age to the stack, then it will push the name, then it will push the ID, then it will push this string. So this string is called format string. And whatever starts with a percentage is called format specifier. So this percentage D, percentage S, and percentage D are called format specifier. So this ID and name and age are called optional argument. So now what printf function does is it will scan this format string. So whenever it encounters the format specifier, it will call the var function. In var function, there is something called valist. It will be pointing to first optional argument. So in our case, it will be pointing to this ID. So whenever var function is called, what it does is it will return the optional argument which valist is pointing to, and it will advance the valist to next optional argument. So now this percentage D will be replaced by 100. Now printf function continue its scanning. So whenever it encounters the percentage S, it will again call the VAR function. So now VAR function will return the whatever VALIST is pointing to, which is this Bob Smith string. And it will advance this VALIST to next optional argument. Now this percentage S will be replaced by Bob Smith string. Now printf function continue its scanning. So whenever it encounters this percentage D, again var function will be called. Now var function will return whatever the valist is pointing to and advance it to next address. So now this 25 will be returned. Now this percentage D will be replaced by 25. Finally, printf function will print this string. So this is how printf function works. So in next slide, let's discuss how format string vulnerability will arise. So this is the exact code we use for example one. So only difference is here we did not pass the age as an optional argument. So whenever main function calls the printf function, so first compiler does is it will push the function parameter in a reverse order, right? First it will push the name, then it will push the ID, then it will push this format string. So now printf function will scan this format string. So whenever it encounters the percentage D, it will call the var function. So in var function, there is something called valist. So initially it will be pointing to ID. So now whenever var function is called, so it will return the optional argument, whichever valist is pointing to. Then it will advance this valist to next address, right? So now this 100 will be returned. Now this percentage D will be replaced by this 100. So again, printf function will continue its scanning. So it encounters the percentage S. Again, it will call the var function. So now this Bob Smith will be returned and this valist will be advanced to next address. So now valist will be pointing here. So now this percentage S will be replaced by this Bob Smith. So now printf function continue its scanning. So whenever it encounters the percentage D, it will call the var function. So now here valist is pointing to this address, right? This block. But this block is not an optional argument. So this block is related to main function because this is the stack frame for main function and this is the stack frame for printf function. So this is the boundary between them. So because here programmer missed the optional argument, so this valist went to out of boundary. So var does not know this. Like var does not know what is the boundary or when to stop. So what var does is it will simply return the value whichever VList is pointing to, and it will advance the VList to next address. So now whatever the value present in this block will be returned by the var function. So this percentage d will be replaced by that value. So we don't know what is the value present here. It might be garbage value or it might be useful information. So that information will be printed by this printf statement, because this percentage d will be replaced by that information, right? So at the end, that will be printed. So this is the leakage of content present in the stack, right? So this is the behavior of format string vulnerability. So I will give a simple demo on how can we utilize this format string vulnerability to leak the useful content present in the stack. So if you look at this code in printf function, programmer missed to include one of the optional arguments, right? So I will run the binary file of this code. Let's see what happens. This example 2. So some garbage value is printed. So I will run it again. Sorry. X is printed. Some garbage value. So it's basically leaking the value present in the stack, right? So let's see another example, example 3. So if you look at this C code, here what programmer trying to do is, he is basically taking the input from the user and he is printing that input using printf function. And here he did not use any format specifier. So let's run the binary file of this code and let's see the behavior of the code. The file name is example 3. So now I will give a simple input, hack rich. So this is the expected behavior of the code, right? It should print whatever the string provided by the user. So I will run the same file again. Now I will provide the format specifier as an input. So let's see what program will output for this input. So if you look at the output, this is not the input I have provided, right? So this is something else. So it's basically leaking the content present in the stack. So let's look at the code, why this behavior is happening. So what is happening here is, this buffer is a user inputted string, right? So now this buffer will be replaced by a user input string. So now this percentage x is treated as format specifier. So what happens is, whenever printf function scans this string, so whenever it encounters a format specifier, it will call the var function. So now var function will return whatever the vlist is pointing to, and it will advance the vlist to next address. So again, this percentage x encountered by the printf function, again that var function is called. And again, it will return something which is pointing to vlist, and it will advance the VList to next address. So this is the reason it is leaking some content from the stack. So let's utilize this vulnerability and leak some useful content from the stack. So let's leak this secret value from the stack. Let's run the binary file. It is example 3. So now I will provide a input around 33 format specifier. I will generate that using Python interpreter. Percentage x dollar star 33. So let's copy this. So I will provide this as an input. So if you look at the output, exact here, it is leaking the value of secret, right? So this is how we can leak the useful content which is present in the stack utilizing this format string vulnerability. So if you wish to leak only secret value, not this garbage value, so we can do that. I will show how to do that. So I'm assuming that it is present at the position 29 or 30 or 31 range. So let's check. It's percentage 30 dollar x percentage 31 dollar x. So it present at 31th position. So now we can directly print them. Well, let's run. Okay. We'll say 31 dollar x. See, it's only leak the value of secret. That's it. No garbage value. So this is how we can utilize the format string vulnerability to leak the content present in the stack. And we can leak some address, useful address, and we can utilize those address to bypass the PHY protection or ASLR protection. So this is all for this video. In next video, let's discuss how can we bypass those protection or PHY or ASLR protection utilizing this format string vulnerability. So until then, stay tuned, like the video, and subscribe the channel.